Ms. Luxon, thank you very much for waking up to talk to us.
Pleasure.
In particular, Gavin Watson will never put his own version now before the state capture inquiry, particularly against Angelo Akritza's shocking claims. How does the commission deal with the veracity of the claims made by Akritza?
Well, it's extremely difficult because, as we all know, dead men tell no tales. So the allegations have been made, and at the moment all that they are is allegations. Until such time as Mr. Watson had given his own version and explained away those particular allegations, we only have one side of the story. Now, as you correctly point out with respect, we never hear his side of the story. So it puts the commissions of inquiry into quite a pickle, because we can't hear his version. And it means that the allegations will stand, but no one can contradict, well, Mr. Watson particularly can't contradict them.
Making matters perhaps even more difficult is the claim by Akritza that Gavin Watson would refuse to put his signature on any document. Does that make the work of the commission that much more difficult to prove anything against the late Gavin Watson now?
Well, absolutely, because, you know, as any investigator will tell you, the paper trail is what one follows, and one looks for documents, you know, one wants documents, one wants to look at who signed them as proof that events took place or didn't take place. Now we've got the double whammy. We haven't got the individual around to explain away the allegations. We haven't got documents to explain away the allegations. So quite frankly, the commission is now has a huge dilemma to face. Mm.
The other important question here, Mr. Loxton, is that at the time of Watson's death, the company, African Global Operations, formerly Bosasa, was undergoing liquidation. How is that affected? Is that affected in any way?
Well, no. The company is a separate entity, so it is separate from its directors and its personnel. So the fact that the company might be facing claims it can't meet and is being wound up should not be affected. Where it could be affected is, you know, arising from liquidations, you often have inquiries in terms of the Companies Act, where directors are called to account. Now we've got one particular individual that was intricately involved in that organization, not there to answer those questions.
It's still astounding, the first few questions I've put to you about, in particular, Angelo Akritza's testimony at the state capture inquiry. What does the commission do now with that volume of what was said there about by Akritza?
Well, as we know, the commission has the powers to make findings and then make recommendations. Now, the first step is to make the findings. It's very difficult for a jurist or a judge or any commissioner to make findings when he's only heard one side of the story. What happens in legal proceedings, you know, often is when an individual refuses to answer allegations or refuses to testify, then the presiding officer can say, well, I gave you a chance to give your version, you chose not to, therefore I've got to decide on the one version only. Now we've got Judge Zondo facing the dilemma that he's heard one side of the story, Mr. Agritzi's allegations, but the individual implicated, without having a say, is not there to answer those allegations. So it's an extremely difficult question to answer as to what Judge Zondo is going to do, because it's not a position I'd like to be in as a jurist.
Perhaps a final question to you. There are lots of questions abound this morning about what actually happened. I'm talking about the accident scene.
Yes.
Should it be found that there was foul play? What are the implications there?
Well, that's a very, very broad question, because, you know, as we know, there's lots of questions being raised in the kind of 24 hours since the accident. People are speculating. I've heard, you know, people saying there's foul play. There's people saying that possibly he decided to take his own life. You know, there's all this kind of these kind of questions being asked. Now, should there be, as you ask, should there be foul play involved? Well, one needs to then hope that the law enforcement agencies will get to the root of that. Who was involved and implicated in that foul play, and for what reason? Was this an organized hit? It would be the question, obviously, people will be asking. Because, as we said right at the beginning, dead men tell no tales, and it's obviously in many people's interests that Mr. Watson is not there to answer the questions.
David Luxon, thank you very much for making the time to come talk to us here. He is with Africa Forensics Cyber joining us this morning.